everybody. Welcome to another episode of Something Else. We're just here in the basement weathering this ice storm going on. You know, hanging with best friends.
Best friends forever.
Best friends forever, Dave. Hey, nice shot. What?
Oh, hey! God!
Son of a bitch!
Okay, Jack, go check out the circuit breaker, and we're going to check out this next sketch.
All right, I'm on it.
Mick, that's not the cue ball!
Let's get retarded in here.
Disrespect, so when I bust my rhyme, you break your necks. We got 5 minutes for us to disconnect from all intellect and let the rhythm affect. Absolutes are inhibition, follow your intuition, free your inner soul and break away from tradition. Cause when we be out, girl, it's pulling weave out. You wouldn't believe how we wow shit out. We burn it till it's burned out, turn it till it's turned out. Act up from northwest, east, south.
Everybody,
yeah.
Everybody, yeah. Let's get into it. Yeah. Get stupid,
come on.
Get retarded,
come on.
Get retarded.
Yeah.
The new iPod Battle Axe is the ultimate consumer product that can protect you from today's common hazards. And yet, it's so simple to use.
The fact that the iPod Battle Axe has GPS satellite technology, taser, stun gun, a weather radar, and it has Star Wars laser technology, as well as can hold 10,000 of my favorite songs, is beyond my mind. And it's only 1 inch thin. And it comes with schnozberry flavor.
See, this one time, I was walking down the street, listening to my favorite tune, Take On Me, the Aha. This ninja just flared up behind me. I knew what to do. Just press this middle button right here. Zapped him away. It's that easy. And with Apple's patented scroll wheel feature, you can kill multiple ninjas at one time.
This iPod is amazing.
This iPod is really amazing.
Do you wanna listen to music, take pictures, track pictures where you are, kill ninjas, get rid of pesky politicians, and secretly record time with your girlfriend? This is all what you need. Quítate los pantalones.
I'm so jealous of these kids today with all these tools they have. They're so much farther ahead of where I was when I was young. The fact that I can blow up buildings with the grenade feature and kill those bullies on the playground makes this iPod weapon essential to my life. I only wish that I could have had this.
I really feel that the world has just really clicked with this design and the wholeness and the world harmony that the solution brings is just feels really, really good.
Back the cats in the cradle in a silver spoon. Little boy blue and the man on the moon.
Friends! I have horrible news!
What?
Jack is missing! And we've run completely out of food sources.
We're all gonna die!
Well, what are we gonna eat?
Ah, son of a bitch!
I bet we've been together for a million years.
And I bet we'll be together for a million more.
Oh, it's like I started breathing on the night we kissed. And I can't remember what I ever did before.
Actually a terrible day. Found out my father has cancer and my sister can no longer conceive children. So how was your day, Schnookums?
Well, after you left, the neighbor came over and we made sweet passionate love until the kids came home.
How was your day, Terrence?
Hey, yo, yo! I done told you already, Pops. My name's not Terrence, it's Teabag. Hey, hey, hey! Guess what, y'all? My hoe's pregnant. Congratulations, you're gonna be grandparents. Yeah.
I was beat up today at school by Jimmy Madison. He stole my lunch money and he called my mother a name.
That's because your mother was a stupid whore.
Yeah, that's what he said.
Well, I'm sure you'll do fine on the spelling test, Billy.
Did you say something, dear?
Bitch, you've ruined my life. I said pass remote.
Not cool.
New Unamazing. You don't have to do any crazy ass shit to open our wrapper.
Well, look who it is, Billy Buttlick. I'm glad you're here. I could use some more money.
Huh, Buttlick. Go on, Jimmy.
Give me that.
Hey! I learned that bullies aren't really bad people. They just have self-esteem issues that they have to work out through aggression.
Yeah, whatever that means.
Ow! Ow! Oh, no!
Yeah.
Stop it! Ow! 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 Ow!
Billy Buttlick! Billy Buttlick!
Oh, what's the matter, little chief?
Jimmy Madison beat me up in the playground!
Oh, no, no one does that for my little brother. Yo, where's the bitch at?
He's at the playground!
Alright, little city regulators, man up. We're gonna get this little hater for messing with my brother.
Word.
Yeah!
hand on your thigh?
Oh, he just came to borrow something.
Yeah, he came to borrow a spoonful of sex from your wife.
Great. Great. Kids, how was your day today?
Hey, yo. I shut up some preschooler on the playground, and now his parents are suing me.
I got beat up in school again today, and I think I have a crush on my friend Timmy.
I gutted a Jehovah's Witness and then played around in his blood.
Larry is Billy's real father.
Great. Well, kids, just remember to take out the trash. And Tweeter, remember to clean up that red liquid in the basement.
One of these days, Dad, I'm gonna stab you in the junk!
Oh, Tweeter!
The following trailer contains 4 men in scenes that may cause audience members varying degrees of discomfort and embarrassment. Especially if you're a millionaire.
If your dog eats better than your butler, you might be a millionaire.
It's the funniest 1% for the richest 1%. It's a laugh break for all those tax breaks.
I have lots of money, yeah. Get it sold.
They call me Escargot.
It's the White Collar Comedy Tour. Starring William England III.
So I took the early flight home from Aspen one day, came home, found my wife cheating on me with our tennis instructor. She asked me, "Are you mad at me?" I said, "No, I'm just glad we have a prenup. Here's where you signed."
Nor Black.
I paid $5,000 for this champagne. It tastes like piss. They call me Escargot.
Barry the stockbroker.
Get it sold. That's quite the catchphrase, isn't it? Get it sold, yeah. Pretty soon people will be buying decals to put that on their cars. Get it sold. With, you know, a picture of me in my hand.
And the richest of them all, Jeff Houndsworthy.
If you've never used your yacht, you might be a millionaire.
The White Collar Comedy Tour. The New Yorker exuberates, "I haven't laughed this hard since I framed my butler for murder."
So my son's nanny came up to me the other day and began to chide me. She said, "You'll need to start giving your son some love and affection before he begins to loathe you." I told her, I said, "If I gave my son love and affection, wouldn't you be out of a job?"
Here's where you sign. I stripped the health benefits from my employees 1 year during flu season. And I took all the money I saved and I put it into pharmaceutical companies I invested. You might be wondering, why did I do that? Because I'm rich and they aren't. They call me Escargot.
If you play golf with Fabergé eggs, you might be a millionaire.
In stores now, coming soon, the No Collar Comedy Tour.
For the good of the council.
The power's only been on for 20 minutes. How could you be hungry?
You were so tasty.
No. No.
Oh, while we cut you, enjoy this next skit.
I hate you guys. Oh, no, no.
My fellow Americans, or my fellow Americans, today the United States has been invaded by the Jolly Green Giant.
Mr. President.
No, that would never. What? Oh.
Mr. President, the other agents and I are going to have to secure the perimeter of the area.
Secure? Are we under a terrorist attack?
Not right now, Mr. President. We just want to take the extra precautions to make sure you're safe. Now, and I'm going to have to leave you by yourself for a little while.
Okie dokie.
In this room. So you're going to, you can do whatever you'd like to keep yourself entertained. There's a computer over there. There's a TV.
Computer? TV?
Yeah, so.
Is there a SpongeBob on TV?
No, I don't know, Mr. President, but I can look into it for you.
Okay.
Okay? Anyways, Mr. President, before I go, something very important. See that button? That red button?
This red button right here.
That button?
Yes.
That's the red button. Whatever you do, do not press that red button.
Do not press this red button.
Right.
Got it. I won't press the red button.
No, no, Mr. President, no. Do not press that red button. If you did that, it could cause worldwide disaster. So whatever you do,
that would be bad for the economy.
Yeah, true. It would be bad for the economy.
Okay.
So, like I said, I'm gonna go. But
don't press the button.
Right. Don't press the button.
Okay, I got it.
All right.
I won't press the button.
No. Mr. President, do not press the button. Okay.
All right.
I gotta get going. But do whatever you want. You know, push-ups, exercise, watch TV. There's snacks, but don't press the button. All right.
Okie dokie.
Okay, sir.
All right.
I'm gonna leave you.
That's fine.
Bye, Mr. President.
Hey, what if I press your buttons? Psychologically. Just kidding. Okay. Don't press the red button. Here's me not pressing the button. God, I want to press this red button so bad. More than anything in my life. You're an evil red button. You make me want to push you. But I can't. That would be bad for the American people. So I won't push you. I'll not push you. Okay. All right, buddy. You want to play? You just mess with Texas. I ain't gonna look at you. You're crafty, but I'm just as craftier. I ate my crafty cheese this morning, so I'm extra crafty. It's getting hot in here, Button. I need to get some Kleenex. You look a little dirty, Button. Need to dust you off a bit. Yeah. It's Button like that. Daddy-like. Yeah, so shiny, so supple. Damn you, Button. Damn you, Button, how'd you see me? I'll make love to you like you want me to, and I'll hold you tight, and I'll press you all night. I'll make love to you like you want me to. You dirty little bitch. What's that, Button? You want to get nasty? Well, I'll show you how nasty Big Daddy Press can get. All right, Button. You want to see how big things come from Texas are? Here we go. You want to get nasty, baby? We're going to do this. Yeah. You like that red button? Yeah.
Oh, Mr. Yes. President. Permission to speak, sir.
Permission granted.
This is awkward. Yeah.
I was just showing the Button who's the big honcho around here.
Well, get dressed. We gotta go.
Okay. All right. W1, Button 0. You hear me, Button? I beat you. Beat you at your own game. My fellow Americans, today, the United States bombed a daycare center. Now, many people have criticized my agenda and my campaign against the war on terror. Well, I received intelligence that this daycare center was actually a breeding ground for angry midget terrorists. And these angry midget terrorists had a stockpile of weapons of mass kablammy. So, after my 3-week resort at Club Med, I will field any questions you have against the War on Terror. So, see you later, alligator.
It's really cold. Everybody's gone over there. I don't know what to do. We had to eat Mick. He fed everybody twice, but he's gone now. I don't know what to do. I'm so scared.
Oh, I found her. Oh. Man, it was just a breaker. Huh. Well, anyway. Hey. Where did everyone go?
They went out to get Chinese food and, well, except for Mick. He's dead. No, he's dead. We ate him.
Alright, so, what happened?
Oh, wow. Man.
Shut up!
Okay.
I'm so full.
So, yeah. Wait, what happened?
Oh, well, what a night, Jack. First we sacrificed Mick. Then we cut him open with a big sword. Then we sifted through his entrails, you know, the tasty ones and the non-tasty ones. And, for some reason, Plow had dibs on the testicles. Like, what did those taste like?
Oh, you know, they were
Yeah, we made a McNuggets joke because his name's Mick and the Nuggets. Yeah, apparently he swallowed an entire plastic lobster. Yeah, we found that in his stomach.
Wait. Oh, wait. I think that was mine.
Yeah, well.
Alright, yeah. I'm thirsty. I'm gonna get a drink or something.
Okay, give me one.
Alright. It's actually milk. I got milk, and that's it. And fresh milk. That's okay. Yes! From my bosom.
Oh. That's it! Yeah! That's the melody of Funky Town!